First, one has to inquire very deeply into what is relationship. Is it merely a pursuit of pleasure or the expression of one's desire? Or is there basically, deeply, love? So, can love exist with desire? Or with pleasure? Or if they exist, love is not. So one has to go into this very carefully to discover for ourselves, if we are at all aware, serious and all that, whether it's possible to live a life in which a relationship doesn't become a conflict. We partially talked about it yesterday. We said our relationship is now based on two separate individuals, two parallel lines like a railway, that they never meet. Perhaps they meet sexually, but otherwise each pursues his own direction. And that relationship becomes distorted. In that relationship there is an enormous amount of conflict, misery, confusion, escaping from that relationship to another kind of relationship. In the new relationships, the same thing exists, and so we carry on. So, the deep cause of this division is thinking that each one is separate. Obviously, I am separate from my wife. I must fulfill in my way and she must fulfill in her way. She must climb the ladder of success socially, and I may not want to climb the ladder of success socially, but I want to climb the ladder of spirituality. So there is conflict between us. Because each person wants his way. Each one is so consumed with his own selfish point of view. Is that the deep root cause of conflict in our relationship? And if it is it possible to totally wipe away this separate feeling? You're following all this? Is that possible? And it may be possible if we begin to understand the nature of ourselves, the structure of myself. What is myself? You understand we are going into it. What am I? A name, a form, right? Certain physical structure. Apart from that, I am the result of thousands of years. Right? My brain has evolved through time, accumulating a great deal of experience, knowledge, both inherited and acquired genetically, which involves time, and the condition in which I've been born. Christian, Hindu, Buddhist, hot climate, hot food, cold climate, not tasty food, and so on. sorry. Also, the religious conditioning, the superstition, the worship of symbols, not the actual, but the worship of symbols, the image created by thought or by thought, by hand. The beliefs, the dogmas, the rituals, you know, all that. My education, my ambition, the whole structure of me is not only the influence of the environment, the cultural, but also the so-called spiritual, religious. And the religious conditioning is merely carrying on old tradition of belief, dogma, rituals, repeating certain meaningless words. So I'm all that. That's what I am. That's what each one of us is. Only different environment, basically the same. And my brain is operating only partially. Please, this is really important to understand if you want to go into deeply. My brain is functioning partially because knowledge is partial. Knowledge can never be complete about anything. Even about the most complex technology, it's not complete. There's always something new taking place. And the accumulated knowledge of experience is very limited. So knowledge always goes with ignorance. So the brain is trained in knowledge and continues to live in ignorance. They're both functioning. I hope you're all. And so the brain is functioning partially because it's based on knowledge. And so whatever it does must be partial. And therefore its action must be partial. And when the action is partial, there must be regrets, pain, anxiety, worry, loneliness, all that follows. And the partial activity of the brain has broken up life. The business life, the religious life, the family life, the spiritual life, the technological, you follow? It's broken it up. Because the brain itself is partial. It's not operating as a whole. Right? Is this somewhat clear between us? Right. So relationship, when based on thought, which it is now, because it is partial, there is division, and therefore conflict.